Hello, welcome to Schools Not Out, your daily classroom for CSEC and CAPE students. You can watch this lesson real time on Television Jamaica's YouTube channel or onespotmedia.com. We are also live Music 99 and GoJamaica.com.
If you have questions on today's subject, you can send them into Television Jamaica's Facebook page or Instagram at Television Jam. Today's lesson, French CSEC. Je suis Mylène Ferreira.
Et je suis Taina Williams. Salut toi!
Bonjour Taina! Bonjour! Comment ça va? Ben oui, on est obligé, hein?
Malgré la COVID, hein? On est là. So, unfortunately, we cannot greet each other as we would normally because of la distanciation.
Oui, tout à fait. Mais bon, qu'est-ce que tu veux? Alors, qu'est-ce qu'on va faire aujourd'hui?
Je pense qu'on est prêt.
Eh oui, on est prêt. Ah oui, les étudiants sont là.
Les étudiants sont là. Alors, bonjour tout le monde. Bienvenue.
Bienvenue à tout le monde.
Je suis Taina Williams, comme j'ai déjà dit.
Et je suis Mylène Ferreira.
Voilà. Nous allons commencer. Alors, notre petite révision commence avec cette diapositive, CSEC French Review, La vie d'un adolescent. And we're looking at the present, the imperfect, and the future tenses.
Alors, quel est le thème d'aujourd'hui?
Ah bon, voilà. La vie d'un adolescent avant, pendant et après la COVID-19.
Attends. Tu as dit la COVID?
Oui.
C'est le ou la COVID?
Alors, c'est la COVID, hein? C'est la COVID-19 selon l'Académie française. On ne dit pas le COVID.
Ah, donc maintenant, alors vous avez entendu, nous allons dire la COVID. D'accord?
Oui, la COVID. Alors maintenant, nous avons un petit dialogue. Écoutez bien. Alors, qu'est-ce que tu fais maintenant, Mylène?
Ah, eh bien maintenant, tu sais, j'envoie des textos à mes amis. Il me manque tellement, tu sais.
Je peux imaginer, oui. Moi aussi.
Et toi, qu'est-ce que tu fais?
J'organise des réunions sur Zoom. Que de réunions sur Zoom. Et je sors au supermarché.
Mais qu'est-ce que tu faisais avant la COVID-19?
Avant la COVID-19, j'organisais des fêtes. Je sortais à la plage. Je faisais toutes sortes de choses beaucoup plus intéressantes.
Et qu'est-ce que tu feras après la COVID-19?
Alors, après la COVID-19, je sortirai encore avec mes amis et j'organiserai des fêtes, je jouerai aussi au tennis.
Moi aussi. Mais je crois que mes étudiants joueront au football.
Ah oui, mais oui. Moi non. Pas du tout, hein? Alors, on va lire ce que nous avons dit.
Est-ce que vous avez compris?
Alors, voilà la première question. Qu'est-ce que tu fais maintenant?
Et moi, j'ai dit, moi, j'envoie des textos à mes amis. Il me manque beaucoup.
Oui, et notez que les mots en rouge indiquent le présent. So the words in red show that we are using the present tense and it is linked to our question, which is, qu'est-ce que tu fais maintenant? And you know what maintenant means, right?
Now.
Okay. Oui.
Et moi, j'ai posé la question, et toi? Et tu as dit?
And I said, j'organise des réunions sur Zoom. I'm organizing meetings on Zoom. Ça me donne mal à la tête.
Et tu as dit, j'en ai marre. I'm fed up with the
meetings on Zoom. And also I said, je sors au supermarché avec ma mère. The only thing I can do is go to the supermarket. Tellement ennuyant, madame.
Oui.
Okay.
et j'ai posé la question, qu'est-ce que tu faisais avant la COVID-19? Et tu as dit...
Oui, et j'ai répondu, j'organisais des fêtes. I used to arrange parties. Je sortais avec mes amis. I used to go out with my friends. Mm-hmm. And again, we want to point out the use of faisait, which is, what tense is that, guys?
Imperfect.
It's the imperfect tense. And then we have j'organisais, I used to organize. And je sortais avec mes amis. I used to go out with my friends.
So, just to look at the endings, A-I-S, A-I-S, j'organisais, je sortais. D'accord? Don't forget the S for the imperfect.
Très bien. But of course, if we were saying he was organizing, then it wouldn't end in S, it would end in T. T. Yes, he or she. On continue. Okay, so then...
J'ai posé la question, qu'est-ce que tu feras après la COVID-19?
Et j'ai dit... Non, j'ai pas dit ça. I did not say that I would play football. Non. But they... I'm very bad at football. Okay, je jouerai au foot avec mes amis, which means I will play football with my friends. And also...
Je sortirai avec ma famille à la plage. So here... Be careful, you have the ending AI, which is different from the AIS in the imperfect, but also something you need to remember with the future. Just like in English, you have an R, you will have an R fera, an R in jouerai, and an R in sortirai. If you don't have any R's, you're not in the future.
Exactly. So the future, if it's a regular verb, the ending gets tacked on to the infinitive.
That's right.
And that's where the R comes from. Très bien. Okay, so, a little more practice. Attention, quel est le verbe? So, rappelez-vous, nous avons regardé le présent, l'imparfait, which is a past tense, and le futur. And then we have the infinitive just to help you remember l'infinitif. So we're going to go through a little practice activity with you now. Alors,
sortir. Au présent, vous donne je sors. À l'imparfait, je sortais. Et au futur, je sortirai. With the R, je sortirai. OK? Donc ça, c'est le premier exemple, Taïna.
Oui, oui.
Alors, maintenant, à vous.
À vous. Alors, nous avons organisé, very easy. Remember that English borrows about 30% of our words from French. So that word organize, it's a French word, we just don't say it the same way. So, organiser, in the present tense, tu organises. In the imperfect, tu organisais. And so what do you think the future is? If we take the infinitive, then we're going to add the AS for tu. So, tu organiseras. Tu organiseras. Mm-hmm.
Alors maintenant, nous avons le verbe jouer, jouer. Donc, elle joue.
Oups.
Quelle est la forme pour l'imparfait? Comme vous le voyez ici, elle jouait avec un T. Et le futur, elle jouera.
Très bien, très bien. Oh, oh là là, qu'est-ce que j'ai fait? Bon, we have... blocked out one column, so sorry. But we will have jouer, to play. Did we just do that?
Yeah, yes. Être.
So now we're doing être, and we have nous sommes, that's the present tense. Nous étions, that's the imperfect. What would be the future? Let us see. The future is...
nous serons.
Ça ne marche pas, monsieur. Nous serons.
Nous serons?
Oui. OK. We are jammed. Ça ne marche pas, monsieur le directeur.
Bien, alors nous allons continuer avec le présent ici, vous. Le verbe avoir, to have, vous donne vous.
Vous avez.
À l'imparfait, vous aviez. Et au futur, vous aurez. So be careful. The difference between avait and aviez is a tiny, tiny I, which you have in the imperfect. Okay? So vous avez et vous aviez for the pronunciation. Okay?
Très bien.
Donc maintenant, nous avons le verbe faire, Taina.
Ok, nous avons le verbe faire. Alors, ils font, c'est le présent. Ils faisaient, c'est l'imparfait. And ils feront, which is the future. Ils feront. Could we have a little help from the director? Our computer is completely jammed. And the student will not be able to see anything. Is there anybody on hand?
Okay, let's move on. So here it's to go. Donc, what's the form of to go present tense? Be careful because aller is the infinitive form, but it's an irregular verb. So it's going to be elles vont, V-O-N-T, elles vont. L'imparfait, elles allaient. Et pour le futur, elles iront. D'accord? Donc, voilà un exercice que vous pouvez faire. You can take a picture of this to see if you can redo it at home. That would be really good. And if you get it right, then you know you've got it.
Okay. So we're getting a little help from our director. And again, we're focusing on the present, the imperfect, and the future. We're going to move very shortly to the situations that you will be having, some examples of situations in the actual exam, the CSEC exam. All right, I think we have it sorted out. Have we got it sorted out, sir?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Nous allons passer aux situations maintenant. D'accord?
But it's not coming up on the screen.
Okay.
Okay, so we will just read it from here for you. Okay, so your friend is going to the beach and asks you to confirm what the weather is like there. And if you were in the oral exam, you would have to tell us, or the written exam, that the weather is bad. But tomorrow it will be a beautiful day. So how do you say the weather is bad and tomorrow it will be a beautiful day in French?
Alors on peut dire il fait mauvais. The weather is bad. Okay. Mais il fera beau demain.
It will be a beautiful day tomorrow.
Also we need to say that there's more than one possibilities. Okay? These are just examples.
Yes.
On peut dire aussi, il pleut maintenant, mais il y aura du soleil demain, par exemple.
Correct. Il pleut maintenant, which means it's raining now, but there will be sun tomorrow. Très bien. We have another situation coming up, and we want you to make sure that you understand that when you're in the speaking part of the exam, this is your time to impress people. This is your time to impress people. But so you can say more than one sentence. If you're in the writing part though, what happens if you say more than one sentence, Mylène?
Well, in the written part, you just need to make one sentence. So you can use commas, okay? And
yes, you just use commas and keep it going to one sentence. So I think we've got it working again. Oh là là, quel problème, n'est-ce pas?
Alors, l'autre situation, donc voilà les...
Okay,
voilà.
We're going to just scoot along. Okay, that's what we were looking at, guys. Mm-hmm. Say the weather is bad now, and we had that going. Il fait mauvais maintenant, mais il fera beau demain. It will be a beautiful day tomorrow. Mm-hmm. And then we had the second possibility.
Il pleut maintenant, mais il y aura du soleil demain.
Excellent, excellent. Now here's another situation, fairly long. You accidentally broke your neighbor's window. Write a note of apology. Now say what you were doing when it broke. And now say what you will do to compensate him or her.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you need to remember note of apology. So the first thing you could say is, je suis désolé. So that is the first thing. Donc, je suis désolé pour la fenêtre. Je jouais au football, mais je paierai la réparation. Une possibilité. Mais nous pouvons aussi dire...
Aussi dire, oui.
Nous pouvons dire, pardonnez-moi, je ne faisais pas attention, mais mon père et moi vous achèterons une nouvelle vitre. Une possibilité.
And notice the words in red. We have in the first section, je jouais. What tense is that, guys? That's the imperfect. And then, I was playing football, mais je paierai la réparation, which is the?
Future. Remember the R I mentioned earlier? Okay. So that is your little clue there.
Mm-hmm. And then your neighbor won't be so upset because you say, pardonnez-moi, je ne faisais pas attention, mais mon père et moi vous achèterons une nouvelle vitre, which is also showing how sorry you are. Mm-hmm. On continue?
Oui, nous continuons.
On continue. Okay.
D'accord. Et donc, nous avons la dernière. So you arrive at the meeting of the French club to find a note saying that the meeting will now take place at a different location. What does the note say?
Mm-hmm. La réunion du club de français aura lieu dans la salle de bain.
Donc, aura lieu, le futur. Aura lieu, aura, is the future of to have. And avoir lieu means to take place.
Yes, so be careful. The French say aura lieu and it means to take place. It doesn't mean to have place. Because I have seen it. Oui. All right, so we must, that's a nice little expression to learn. Avoir lieu, to take place.
Où la réunion du club de français sera dans la salle de B au lieu de, which means instead of. Okay, a good expression to remember.
Excellent. So those are our situations, but we want to point out some tips to help you. And Mylène va expliquer ce que vous devez savoir.
Alors, pour les situations, petite astuce, tips. Read the situation very carefully, okay? If the situation says something about your friend, you know that if you have your friend, you're going to have to use tu. And if you use tu, you have to think about te, toi, ton, ta, te, but not vous or votre or vos. And of course, if you have to say please, it will have to be s'il te plaît as opposed to s'il vous plaît. So we have to think about that carefully and also think about the tenses. So all this, we said it before, written work, it's one sentence only and all work more than one sentence. Alors maintenant, nous allons passer à la compréhension de l'écrit.
Oui, la compréhension de l'écrit en anglais, it means reading comprehension. The French say comprehension of what is written, compréhension de l'écrit. But in English, we say reading comprehension.
Okay.
Okay. And before we look at that, however, we want you to focus on the questions, okay? The questions which go with the reading comprehension guide you. Alors, n'oubliez pas de regarder les questions à la fin, avant de lire la compréhension. And here we have our questions.
Is the writer male or female? Justify 2 points for that. Where did the writer usually spend the summer and what did he or she do there for 2 points? What is special about La Marina à Bas-du-Fort? Another 2 points. And give an example of a geste barrière as mentioned in the text for 1 point. And what will the writer do after COVID-19 for 3 points?
Okay, and this word geste barrière, it will come back. So please make a note of it. It is a very interesting piece of vocabulary. Oui, mademoiselle, mon ami, continue.
Alors, donc je vais lire le texte maintenant. Écoutez bien. Avant la COVID-19, j'allais tous les ans à Pointe-à-Pitre rendre visite à ma correspondante Nathalie. Elle m'invitait en juillet et je l'invitais en Jamaïque en août. C'était un échange linguistique. Nous sommes restés de bons amis.
We have time for two, you think? Okay, I'm going to read it again for our people who are listening on the radio. Avant la COVID-19, j'allais tous les ans à Pointe-à-Pitre rendre visite à ma correspondante, Nathalie. Elle m'invitait en juillet et je l'invitais en Jamaïque en août. C'était un échange linguistique. Nous sommes restés de bons amis.
Ok, je continue. Nous aimions nous promener près du Memorial Act. Il y faisait très bon grâce à la brise. Le soir, nous passions du temps à regarder les grands bateaux à la Marina Bas du Fort. C'était un endroit plein de bars et de restaurants, toujours animé jusqu'au petit matin.
Ah, nous aimions nous promener près du Memorial Act. Il y faisait très bon grâce à la brise. Le soir, nous passions du temps à regarder les grands bateaux à la Marina Bas du Fort. C'était un endroit plein de bars et de restaurants toujours animés jusqu'au petit matin.
Mm-hmm. C'était de bons souvenirs. Mais maintenant, on ne peut plus voyager à cause de la COVID-19. Cependant, nous communiquons en ligne. Nathalie m'envoie des photos d'elle avec son masque ou lorsqu'elle se lave les mains, car elle le fait régulièrement. Ce qui sont les gestes barrières pour combattre ce virus.
Ah, les gestes barrières. Again, I will repeat because we know we have some people who cannot see the screen. So I will repeat this section. C'était de bons souvenirs, mais maintenant, on ne peut plus voyager à cause de la COVID-19. Cependant, nous communiquons en ligne. Nathalie m'envoie des photos d'elle avec son masque ou lorsqu'elle se lave les mains, car elle le fait régulièrement. Ce qui sont les gestes barrières pour combattre ce virus.
Mm-hmm. Quand la vie reprendra son cours normal, je l'inviterai à passer 2 semaines à Montego Bay chez mes grands-parents. Cette fois-ci, elle connaîtra les chutes de Duns River, une attraction que nous n'avons pas encore faite.
Et rapidement, quand la vie reprendra son cours normal, je l'inviterai à passer 2 semaines à Montego Bay, chez mes grands-parents. Cette fois-ci, elle connaîtra les chutes de Duns River, une attraction que nous n'avons pas encore faite.
Alors maintenant, nous allons passer aux questions. Is the writer female or female? Female, it has to be a female, Nathalie.
Yeah, but look, on va vérifier, madame. Nous sommes restés de bons amis. Notice, il y a un E, one E. And bons amis, no N, only, pardon, one N, pas deux. And no E, so L.
Okay, I got it wrong.
Oui. Ce n'est pas une femme, ce n'est pas une fille. Next question.
Where did the writer usually spend the summer and what did he, I can say now, do there?
Okay.
The writer used to go to Guadeloupe to visit his pen pal. So if you say the first one gives you 1 point, the second 1 point, this is the justification. J'allais tous les ans à Pointe-à-Pitre rendre visite à ma correspondante Nathalie. You need to remember that Pointe-à-Pitre is in Guadeloupe. Okay?
And you also need to remember that when you're talking about people, you cannot say je visite. No, no, no. You have to say je rends visite à ma correspondante. I pay a visit to my pen pal. All right? So we cannot say je visite ma correspondante. We have to say je rends visite à ma correspondante.
What's special about la Marina Bas du Fort? For 2 points, what's special? Many bars, restaurants, 1 point and big boats, and it's lively until dawn. And we got that in le soir, nous passions du temps à regarder les grands bateaux à la Marina Bas du Fort. C'était un endroit plein de bars, full of bars, plein de bars et de restaurants, toujours animé, which is lively, jusqu'au petit matin, until dawn.
Yes, and we would like to point out again that this word petit matin is dawn. That is a good expression to learn. It does not mean until the little morning. It means jusqu'au petit matin, just until dawn. Très bien. All right, this was the expression I pointed out earlier, n'est-ce pas? Geste barrière. What do you think a geste barrière is? Because we're asking you now to give two examples that you heard in the text.
Wearing a mask and washing your hands regularly.
Yes, and so the English for a geste barrière, write this down. You might want to use it in your orals with your examiner. So a geste barrière is a protective measure or a barrier measure. We say that sometimes too in English. Voilà. Okay, so we're going to look now at the last question.
What will the writer do after COVID-19 for 3 points? So the writer will invite Natalie to Jamaica, that's 1 point, and will take her to visit his grandparents who live in Montego Bay, another point. And he will also take her to Dance River Falls.
1 point. Okay.
So how many points did you get? Combien de points?
Right. I hope you got them all right. Have a quick look. Reprendra son cours normal. When life will become normal again, will take back its normal course. Je l'inviterai à. I will invite her to. Notice we have an apostrophe which takes the place of the la. Instead, we get l'inviterai. We have cette fois-ci, which means this time. And we have chute, which means falls. It is not a curse or an exclamation. Chute means the waterfalls.
Yes.
All right. And now we are going to just have a few little pointers.
Well, just here for you to, in case you didn't know those words which were used in the text. Grâce à, thanks to. Souvenirs, you know that it can be souvenirs, but also memories. À cause de, because of. Cependant, however, which is very good to use, especially in your writing. And en ligne, online.
Right. Okay, so we are, and here's a picture of le Memorial Act, which is a beautiful museum in Guadeloupe. When we come back, because we're going to break in a few seconds, we'll talk a little bit more about this. It is a most exquisite experience. I understand, because I have not gone there. So TVJ School's Not Out, we'll be right back. We hope you have enjoyed it so far.
À bientôt. À tout à l'heure.
Hi there, I'm Simon Preston from TVJ. Thank you very much for watching our YouTube channel. To see our latest videos and also to see live events, click here. To see our full videos on onespotmedia.com, click here. Thank you very much.
Reduce your risk of viral illnesses like the flu and coronavirus. Wash your hands frequently with soap and water. Cover your nose and mouth when coughing with a tissue and dispose of it. Avoid close contact with anyone with the cold or flu-like symptoms. If you become ill, please visit your doctor or the nearest health center and share your travel history. The flu and coronavirus can kill. Let's protect each other. A message from the Ministry of Health and Wellness.
Hi there, I'm Simon Preston from TVJ. Thank you very much for watching our YouTube channel. To see our latest videos and also to see live events, click here. To see our full videos on onespotmedia.com, click here. Thank you very much for watching.
COVID-19 tip. Protect yourself and others from getting sick by washing your hands after coughing or sneezing, when caring for the sick, before, during, and after you prepare food, before eating, after toilet use, when hands are visibly dirty, and after handling animals or animal waste.
Hi there, I'm Simon Preston from TVJ. Thank you very much for watching our YouTube channel. To see our latest videos and also to see live events, click here. To see our full videos on onespotmedia.com, click here. Thank you very much for watching.
Reduce your risk of viral illnesses like the flu and coronavirus. Wash your hands frequently with soap and water. Cover your nose and mouth when coughing with a tissue and dispose of it. Avoid close contact with anyone with the cold or flu-like symptoms. If you become ill, please visit your doctor or the nearest health center and share your travel history. The flu and coronavirus can kill. Let's protect each other. A message from the Ministry of Health and Wellness.
Hi there, I'm Simon Preston from TVJ. Thank you very much for watching our YouTube channel. To see our latest videos and also to see live events, click here. To see our full videos on onespotmedia.com, click here. Thank you very much for watching.
COVID-19 tip. Protect yourself and others from getting sick by washing your hands after coughing or sneezing, when caring for the sick, before, during, and after you prepare food, before eating, after toilet use, when hands are visibly dirty, and after handling animals or animal waste.
Welcome back to Schools Not Out, where we are discussing CSEC French.
If you have any questions on what we've done so far, you can send them in our various platforms and we will see if we can answer in the final segment.
Excellent. We want to point out something because we were rushing a bit at the end. We have a game, a little quiz that you can log on to. So you go to joinmyquiz.com and you enter the game code, which is written right here, 1, 2, 6, 2, 9, 8, okay? So you log on, you play this game, and it will help you review some of the points we were looking at. Now, we promised that we would tell you a little bit about Le Memorial Act in Guadeloupe.
Alors, Le Memorial Act, c'est un centre caribéen et c'est comme un musée, en fait, un musée où on peut découvrir ce qui s'est passé pendant la traite de l'esclavage. Le petit E de acte, c'est E pour esclavage, slavery. And this is a very good place to go to and learn so much about.
So this is a wonderful museum in Guadeloupe, in Pointe-à-Pitre. I say wonderful, I have no idea because Mylène was telling me all about it. I learned about it. It's fairly new. When I went to Guadeloupe, it wasn't there yet. And we're going to move ahead now. We've mentioned the quiz. So I want you, as soon as we finish this program, jouons en ligne. We'll play it online, okay? But now let's talk about les devoirs.
Ah, les devoirs. Tout le monde aime les devoirs.
Okay, so homework.
We have selected a letter for you because you know you're going to have to do a lot of writing. Okay, for your exam. So this is one letter, 130, between 130 and 150 words. So
okay, so write a letter to your friend, your French pen pal, telling him or her about your summer activity. My students, if you're watching this, take this down, please. Okay, in your community, the activities in your community to help teenagers enjoy themselves after COVID 19. And the letter must be between 130, 130 and 150, 150 words.
So be sure to include some of the activities offered for teenagers, a description of an activity you took part in, and why you enjoyed it so much, your friends' reactions to the activities they took part in, and future plans for other summer events. So as you can see here, several tenses will be used here, okay? Right. So the activities offered for the teenagers, and then the reactions. I remind you that when you're talking about reactions, feelings, you also need to use the imperfect tense, not just for when you want to say, I used to. And future plans, of course, you will need to use the future. Okay? And so this is to be sent. Mm-hmm.
But hold on, before we go ahead, remember to plan your letters carefully. Don't just give us a block of writing. That is hard for us to understand. Remember also to give us an address. You have to show us that you know how to say these things in French. You have to show us that you can set up a letter and start appropriately. Comment est-ce qu'on dit bonjour dans une lettre, par exemple? You don't say bonjour mes amis, no. You say chère Mylène or cher Pierre. Mm-hmm. And then you say salut if it's a very good friend and you're being very casual and very warm. And you must end in such a way that we know that it's a letter. So you can say je t'embrasse or
amitié.
Amitié, love. But don't say sincèrement. The French do not write sincèrement. Okay? So amitié, je t'embrasse. So let's go on a little bit with some more information. This is where you have to send your homework.
Donc envoyez vos devoirs à la JAFT, Jamaica Association of French Teachers. jaftjamaica@gmail.com. Et la date limite, le 3 juin. Je répète, le 3 juin.
And notice how she said the deadline, la date limite. The final date, la date limite. I have seen students write la ligne morte.
Oh!
The deadline, no, la date limite. Très bien. Okay, now then, to cheer ourselves up. Maybe some of you will have a real graduation ceremony, maybe some of you will have a virtual ceremony, but what we want to know is, après la cérémonie de remise des diplômes,
que feras-tu?
What does that mean?
Mm-hmm. What will you do?
What will you do? So we're using which tense, guys? We're using the future. So, qu'est-ce que tu feras, Mylène?
Tu me connais, je ferai la fête, bien sûr.
Elle fera la fête. Ah, je voudrais le faire avec toi. Je voudrais sortir avec toi. But malheureusement, je continuerai avec mes études. Je continuerai avec mes études. I will continue with my studies.
Mais j'avais des plans pour partir en vacances. Ah. Alors, peut-être, je partirai en vacances. D'accord? Si la COVID, s'il n'y a plus.
Où est-ce que tu iras?
J'irai aux États-Unis.
Aux États-Unis?
Oui, j'avais planifié.
Folle.
Oui, je sais, j'avais planifié.
Do you hear where she wants to go?
C'était planifié.
She wants to go to the United States for her holidays. Moi, non, je reste en Jamaïque.
Très bien,
I am staying here. Je vais à la plage. I'm going to the beach, but then after, je travaillerai. I will work some more. Je suis comme ça, très travailleuse. Mm-hmm. Tandis qu'elle, elle fait la fête.
Pourquoi pas?
Her life is very exciting. C'est très bien. All right, guys. We are actually going to talk a little bit before we go to this. Let me go back here. Let's go back. We forgot to mention that in France, they don't have a graduation ceremony. They don't have a graduation ceremony the way we would in Jamaica or what we're used to. Mm-hmm. Qu'est-ce qu'on fait, Mylène, en France?
On court avec les résultats. J'ai réussi. Et après, on fait la fête. C'est tout. Il n'y a pas de cérémonie.
So you notice that après la cérémonie de remise des diplômes, it says the ceremony where you get your diploma, but it doesn't call it a graduation because they don't have that. But she does talk about les fêtes, the parties.
Oui, la fête.
La fête, very important.
Beaucoup de fêtes.
So guys, don't say la graduation. That is not a word that French speakers use when they talk about leaving high school. They talk about la cérémonie de remise des diplômes. Okay? Is there anything else you would like to tell us about the school system in France?
Not really. I think because of time, I think we need to continue.
Okay. But remember, they don't have CSEC. They don't have that level.
No, they don't have CSEC. That's true. The very big exam is the baccalaureate when you're 18.
Yes.
So that's why there's this party, this boom.
Yes.
Because, you know, you have to wait for 18 years before you get that.
So you cannot graduate after fifth form. You cannot graduate from high school at 16 as you do in Jamaica. You have to go all the way through to sixth form.
Unless you go to some
technical school, but then you still have to do those 2 years. Have to do 2 years. You have to go till you're 18. All right, so maintenant, un petit poème pour terminer. Elle va présenter un poème qu'elle a écrit pour vous.
Eh oui, j'écris un poème spécialement pour toi, adolescent. Alors, je vais le lire, d'accord? La vie d'un adolescent. La vie d'un adolescent. Quoi de plus intéressant? Tes passions avec cette crise, ce n'est que partie remise. Avec toi, une chose de sûre, l'important, c'est ton futur. Alors, arrête, ne stresse pas, tu auras de bons résultats.
So, I'll try to summarize it. So beautiful. So, a teenager's life is so interesting. But now, in this COVID pandemic, all the things you love have had to be put off. But she's saying, don't worry, because one thing is certain. Your future will be bright, so stop stressing. You're going to have great results in your exam. Alors, ne stresse pas. Do not stress yourselves. And we're going to talk a little bit more about the team who put this all together. Mm-hmm. So we say to you, merci et bonne chance aux examens.
Les cinq lettres.
And here we want to talk about the team who helped us so well. We have, well, of course, Mylène and myself, but we have this team behind
Elsa,
us.
Elsa Calliar-Burton.
Amanda Crawford, some Elie of our
Zendala.
Best teachers. Elie Zendala, yes.
Leonie Wallace.
And Madame Shelley Wong. And we all work together on this presentation. And we also want to thank our friend Roxane Lovelace.
Qui est la responsable du français en Jamaïque.
Oui, au ministère d'éducation. She works in the Ministry of Education. We could not have done this without her. And we just want to say, guys, when you're in your exam and you make a mistake, do like we did.
Yes.
Just keep going, just keep going. Because I have had students ask me, what do I do to make sure that I can actually perform? What can I do? And so we were going to just tell you that when you warm up beforehand, you will be more prepared to speak.
Yeah, that's right.
Any other tips that you would like to share?
Well, I think that the results for the quiz will be available on the JAFT Instagram page by the end of the day.
Yes.
So please try. That's all today for French CSEC today, you know?
And we hope you grasp some of the points we discussed. You can catch a repeat of today's lesson on JNN today at 5 p.m. in the School's Not Out highlights on Saturday between 1 and 4 p.m. It's also on video on demand, One Spot Media, CSEC Social. Oops, that's all for now. Oh, CSEC Social Studies is coming up soon, so until next time. Je suis Taina Williams.
Et je suis Mylène Ferreira. Au revoir.
Bonne journée. À la prochaine.
Au revoir.
Hi there, I'm Simon Preston from TVJ. Thank you very much for watching our YouTube channel. To see our latest videos and also to see live events, click here. To see our full videos on onespotmedia.com, click here. Thank you very much.
Reduce your risk of viral illnesses like the flu and coronavirus. Wash your hands frequently with soap and water. Cover your nose and mouth when coughing with a tissue and dispose of it. Avoid close contact with anyone.